Well, Buglers, we have listened to you, so please welcome, fresh from Las Vegas County Jail, the American!
How you doing, everybody?
You're looking good. No, and you're looking good.
Oh,
how's it going?
God. Look at this guy. Oh, what do you got? Glasses on? Nice touch. Nice touch.
That's a little Vegas opening there. Everybody. What's that? Working the crowd.
Yeah, I'm working the crowd a little bit. You know what I mean? Look at this. I like you in the engineering booth. You look sharp. You look sharp.
Oh, we haven't seen each other since Vegas, have we, American? That's the
you're
last
right.
time we spoke.
You're right. And there may be a connection of why I haven't been on the show. I'm not gonna say full prosecution or arrest. I'm just gonna say I've been out of town. You know what I'm saying, right, ladies? I've been out of town, right, ladies? Come on.
Did you end up or down in Vegas?
When you have your head in a vice, is that up or down? Which is that? I forget.
I think that's down.
Oh, yeah.
Down.
Okay, so down a bit. Yeah, down a bit.
And how about your brother? How's he?
He's okay. Let's just say he's okay.
Okay.
I don't want to get too specific right now because my attorneys have advised me not.
Well, first...
But what a town, Vegas, huh? Only in the USA can we have a place like Vegas.
Well, first we should say congratulations on your moment of history, American.
Yeah, you're welcome. What do we do again? What thing haven't we done that's history in the last 200 plus years?
Yeah, well, let's not dwell on that, but let's just... I was primarily thinking you the first African-American president of the United States.
That was exciting. It was pretty exciting.
Yeah.
You got to expect it from us first. I mean, no other country has ever had a black leader except us. Boom. We won. We got there first.
Hold on a second. I think
we did it. First country in the world to have a black guy in charge. We did it.
Simply not true.
USA. USA.
Yeah, I know. I understand. It's a very rhythmic chant.
You're supposed to join in, but you know, you'll understand that.
Most African nations have had black leaders for quite some time.
I got to check that. I'm pretty sure what made this history was the fact that we're the first country in the world to have a black guy in charge.
I mean, really,
and that says something.
Must insist that is not the case. I don't want to diminish this because it's an amazing thing that happened here, but you cannot claim that.
Okay, wait, hold on. We're the first country in the world to have a black guy in charge. I just claimed it. And what are you going to do about it? Nothing. Because what are you going to do? Are you going to have Africa invade us? What do they have? Pickup truck with a guy and a machine gun on the back. Come on over, Africa. We're waiting for you.
They got pirates now.
Oh, boo, pirates. I'm so scared. What are you going to do? Take me out my jet ski? What are you going to do with your pirates?
Are you suggesting that Robert Mugabe is, in fact, white?
I'm suggesting Robert Mugabe's not really a leader. He's a terrorist.
I see.
Yeah. Right, you see, those guys, you're giving them the credit they want you to give them.
Right.
They're acknowledging them as leaders. And I'm saying those guys aren't leaders. Those guys are terrorists.
I see. So it's a blanket
Because unless you lead people the right way, you're not really a leader.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
What does that even mean?
It's a philosopher's term. It's a term of philosophy.
You can't just say
something. Reading a little bit about philosophy.
It's a philosopher's term.
Descartes. I've been reading a little bit of that stuff, you know.
Obviously, the big story at the moment in America is the American economy.
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
I feel great about it. We're booming. We're always booming over here.
No, you're not. You're collapsing.
Well, but that's what everyone keeps saying. You understand? And like, there's two things happening. There's a psychological economy and there's the real economy. And the psychological economy is everyone on the news saying, oh no, the economy's collapsing, we're screwed.
Yeah.
Just like they said, killer bees are gonna come get us. Oh yeah, where am I alive? Am I dead from bees? No. Am I dead? No, I'm still alive. Oh, SARS, bird flu, monkeypox. Yeah, the economy. I don't believe any of the crap they spew. There's always something to go. The Black Plague is 2 weeks away, yeah? Suck on it.
Yeah.
America is not going anywhere, baby.
Yeah.
The world would like to think that, but no, we're winning again.
Right.
The best economy in the world. And guess what happens? They say our economy's bad. The whole world ripples. There's a whole ripple through the whole world.
Well, that's...
And that's what people have to understand. We are the world economy, so people better come here and spend their money.
Well,
boom.
I mean, that much is true. You know, that there was the Davos World Economic Summit.
Right.
And, I mean, America came in for some very stern criticism there for basically screwing the world economy. I mean, how do you respond to that?
Well, you know, this is a very frustrating topic for me, and I don't want to get too heated, but how can we be blamed for screwing the world economy when we are the reason there is a world economy? In other words, everyone wants, everyone sees what we do and then they emulate it. It's like, okay, look, they have sneakers. Now we want sneakers. You know, like, sneakers didn't exist, except they were invented here by Nike, and then everyone over there was going, oh, we're making them. Just because we're making them here, I guess we want them now, too. You know, like, oh, because I'm 15 and I'm on an assembly line making an American sneakers. Now I got to wear them? No. So it's like we created that world economy. We've got people in India picking up our phone calls. Boom. World economy. That's us. We've got people in China buying our cars. Boom. World economy. So, so they're benefiting from America, and yet complaining about how great we are. I don't understand. There's a again, to quote, you know, a philosopher, it's you're damned either way.
So does this mean, given that America's influence on the global economy, that we can expect the pretzel dog to enter the British food market within the next year or so?
Yeah, you believe me, I've eaten British food. You better hope the pretzel dog gets there.
Now, you mentioned China is buying American cars. I would point out that no one is buying American cars, including you.
That's absolutely untrue. I drive a Toyota pickup truck that's built right here in the United States of America.
That's a Japanese
and you'll notice,
car.
And you but it's built in the USA now. I mean, so what's the difference? And wait, hold on. You've seen my car. Do I not have a magnet on the back that says support our troops and an American flag on the back? So I just, okay, American car. Define what an American car is. It's a car driven by an American that says he supports our troops. Boom. American. I think you're confusing an American car with a car that's built by an American company.
That's interesting. That's maybe
words,
you're right.
Yeah, like if I see a little Japanese man driving a Bugle, Japanese car. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he's swerving in and out. He doesn't know where he's going. He's from Japan.
And, of course, as well, you just had the Super Bowl. Greatest show on Earth.
Greatest show on Earth. We did it again. Super Bowl. World champions, and we're the only ones in it.
Yeah.
That's right, world. You don't even need. Don't even bother having an American football team because we don't need you to have one. We're the world champions. How about that? How about that? Arizona plays Pittsburgh. Boom. World champions. Did Arizona play Athens, Greece? No. That would be a world game. We don't even need to have a world game to have world champions. That should say something about how dominant we are.
Are we rooting for a particular team?
We don't need your permission, is what I'm saying. Of course I was rooting for a particular team. Pittsburgh Steelers. It's a real American team. The team's named after steel, which is an American product. You know? We invented steel.
No, you didn't invent steel.
Pretty sure we did. Pretty sure we did.
You've annoyed the world with part of the stimulus package, which states that from stimulus projects should all be American goods. They should buy American.
Yeah.
Which is, I mean, that technically it's illegal under the world trade rules.
No, but we're just telling Americans to buy American goods. We're not telling everyone has to.
Yeah, I know, but that's...
Well, in other words, if it doesn't matter what we do and you don't want to deal with us, then what would you care if we didn't buy, you know... I mean,
it's not fair, though, is it? It's not
Why
fair.
Why isn't it fair?
Well, because...
I mean, made in the USA. It should say that on the back before you buy it.
But, I mean, could you not just buy other people's things and slam a little magnet saying support the troops USA on it?
That doesn't make any sense. In other words, how can you buy something that's made in France and then put a sticker on it and now it's made in America?
But I thought that's what you just said with cars.
No, I said those cars are built here. They're built them by American hands.
I'm lost, Andy. I'm lost.
Built by American hands.
I thought he was making sense, and then it's all falling apart again.
The French opened a Freedom Fry factory, let's say, somewhere in the United States, and I was buying those fries from that company, even if a French guy was behind it. I mean, I personally wouldn't buy anything from the French just because I don't trust them. You know what I mean? And I think to be honest with you, I think they're obnoxious people. I mean, I've had a few times where I'm on the subway or something, a f***ing French guy gets on, where am I going? Oh. I don't know where you're going. I'll go back to, if you don't know where you're going, what are you doing here? You know what I'm saying? I got to give you instructions now on where to go.
But didn't the French basically invent half of America, though?
What? I'm sorry, what'd you just say? Say that again. I didn't hear. Was that an email? Because if that wasn't an email, I prefer not to answer. I don't mind answering emails, but that seems like you're just trying to get under my skin. I know that they did some stuff in Canada, and I could tell you this. If we felt like it, we could take whatever they did in Canada. In about, I would say, three moves on the Stratego board. We don't Canada.
But pretty much, you know, the whole of the central part of America, that was France. You just bought it off the French. You're basically French.
Look,
he's gone purple,
tell you right,
Andy.
I'll
he's
tell you
purple.
Right now.
There's smoke coming out of his ears.
Look, he's smelling of garlic.
Let me clarify. I'll give you one piece of land we bought from the French, okay? And it's a piece of land that was built poorly, and it's Louisiana. And there's a reason that that hurricane did so much damage down there. It's because it's French built. So what we have to do, we got to build that wall with American people and American engineers, and we got to take all the French out of that city, and then it'll get back to itself.
Is that why you built your own Eiffel Tower in Las Vegas?
That was a gag. We did that that was like a dare. The guy was like, I dare to build an obnoxious French thing in Vegas. And the other guy was like, I got enough money, I'll do it.
And finally, what did you think of Bruce Springsteen at the Super Bowl?
That guy is what it's all about.
You're filling up, aren't you? Your eyes are filling
up. Oh, Jesus Christ. I mean, it's a beautiful thing. I mean, first of all, guy's almost 6 years old.
Yeah.
He's just sliding around the stage like he's got ants in his pants over there. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what he's doing. He's jumping, he's dancing, he's singing. Hey, by the way, you notice with him too, it's always clean. He doesn't ever go blue. I respect that.
Oh, you know, really?
What I mean? He doesn't ever drop an F-bomb, you know, or a swear word. Never. He's always singing clean, and he's always thinking about one thing, being born right here in the USA.
Yeah, but, I mean, you do understand that song was really a critique of Vietnam.
Which song was that? Born in the USA?
Yeah.
That's... No, I think that song was actually about how great it is to be born in the USA. I'm pretty sure. I mean, it's called Born in the USA. I don't really know why everything's a debate today with you guys.
Have you ever listened to the verses of those songs?
Yeah, Born in the USA. I was born in the USA. And then blah, 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 born in the USA. I know the song. I grew up listening to that song.
It's the blah, 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 blah bit. I think you might want to listen to a bit more.
And everything he says about New Jersey, you know, and then sometimes he'll think about other places in New Jersey, you know.
Right.
And then he's got that song about being from Jersey.
Yeah.
You know, and I love that other one about how, like, Jersey's, like, got swamps, you know. I mean, he's got just so much of it, his home, you know, mainly because I'm from Jersey, you know. But other than that, I mean, the guy is the boss, you know. It's like... Can't call someone the boss if they're not in charge. That's all I'm saying.
Well, do you have any message, any concluding message for the world in terms of people trying to recover their economies at the moment?
Yeah, I would say buy American goods.
No, that's not going to help. People don't want to hear that.
Well, I remember growing up, my dad would say things like, oh, you know, like, don't eat paste, don't smoke cigarettes. And I didn't want to hear it, but I didn't do it. So this is the same thing. It's us to the world. It's like a parent, and I'm telling the world what's best for them. That's all I'm trying to do. You might not want to hear it, but if you listen, it will end up being the right thing to do. If you buy American goods, a few things will happen, okay?
Yeah.
You buy American goods. Let's just make up a product, okay?
Okay.
Let's call them American widgets, okay?
Okay.
That's just a very basic, that's like a fake thing. You buy American widgets. Now, me, Mr. American Widget Maker, now he's got a lot of money.
Okay.
So what do? Maybe I take a trip. I take a trip to some place like Las Vegas, okay? Now, I spend a lot of money at a casino in Las Vegas.
Uh-huh.
Some French guy comes in. He wins a slot machine. Why does that slot machine have money in it? Because I spent a lot of my money there. Now, he goes home with money from that slot machine, and he spends it on like a French bread at a bakery or whatever they eat over there. I have no idea. Cheese and bread, I don't know, and cigarettes, whatever they do over there, and berets, right? So now he's buying from some French guy berets. Where did he get that money? America. So all you people have to do is come over here, win in a casino, you know, hopefully not steal it, but whatever, somehow figure out how to get the money back from us, and then spend it in your countries. The money's here. You just have to come and figure out how to get it.
So
it's a motivator.
That's
how the economy works. It's
that's
a world
your interpretation
economy.
Of trickle-down economics.
It's not trickle-down. It's
into casinos.
It's Amerocentric, okay? They used to think the world revolved around the earth, and they, oh, no, it revolves around the sun, right?
Yeah.
That world keeps saying, oh, the world revolves around the world. No, it revolves around America. We're the sun. All you guys have to do is come close to the sun and take a little bit of the heat. That's all you got to do. It's right here for you. It's so simple.
Oh, it makes sense again, Andy. He's done it
again. Next thing you know, the baker in France, he's sitting pretty.
American, thank you once again for your words of wisdom and bridge building.
You guys are great. I always have fun with you guys.
Right, I'm afraid that has taken up the space for your email, so we will have a special extended email section next week, including all your complaints or praise for the American. Do keep your emails coming in to thebugle@timesonline.co.uk, and we've had some absolute corkers this week, so we'll be reading them out next week when they're slightly out of date.
And now! You know what that music means. You should already have stopped driving or just crashed into a tree in anticipation. He's back, baby! US! You know the rest of it. It's the American!
Hey, how you doing, everybody? Yeah, nice to be here.
I tried to give you a... I mean...
Hey, fellas.
With a British voice, it's difficult to give you an introduction that big. I think I might have pulled something in my throat.
Say, I think you might have pulled your Adam's apple.
Yeah. I don't think you can do that, but good point.
Well, look, you could. You could. And I'm going to just say this real quick. Fellas, you know, the phones work two ways here. You know, I don't know how your tellies work over there, but, you know, ours ring here. Give me a little dingle-dingle on your telly, and I'll come in anytime.
That actually made even less sense.
Yeah, you know, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. I mean, you know, I mean, maybe you're home, you know, eating fags or something.
Yeah.
I don't know what you guys do.
You're trying. And I appreciate that, but it's just not enough.
It's great to have you back, American. Been a lot of Buglers have been asking about your whereabouts. Alex, who claims to be a secret agent in Washington, D.C.,
mm-hmm.
asks, where the heck is the American? Come on!
Yeah. Right,
three exclamation
good job.
Marks.
Way to blow your cover, Alex.
Yeah.
Unimpressive.
Bad secret agent, Alex. Bad.
Let me tell you another thing, Alex. If somebody ever tells you they're in the mob, they're not in the mob. The mob doesn't tell you. They let you know different ways. A vice doesn't only hold wood. That's all I'll say.
And Denise Luzal from Costa Rica writes, when Hello. Is the American coming back? I don't know if that's just referring to Central America in general. When are the Americans coming back?
I like that name, too. Denise Luzal, Costa Rica. Let her know if I ever get out there. I'll look her up.
Okay.
But she should definitely send me a photo first so I know if it's worth the trip.
Do not do that, Denise. Do not do that. And shame on you as well. Shame on you for what you just said there.
Hey, it's the internet age. You got to look at someone before you meet them.
Stop it.
This email came from David Tanner in Bristol, who asked, what is the Americans' opinion on healthcare?
You've been taking a lot of pot shots at the way we British people look after ourselves.
Yeah.
You've been doing a lot of that in America, haven't you?
I don't know that they're pot shots as much as we're just stating facts. British people are naturally unhealthy. I don't think it has as much to do with the healthcare system as it has to do with just straight genetics. You guys are cut from a different cloth. And your cloth is made out of what I would call maybe like a silk or something, very light and fluffy.
It's made from a steel weave.
Yeah, I would disagree. I feel like ours is made from maybe, that stuff from Lord of the Rings that, like, nothing could get through. That's a good movie.
Yeah, but they never
have. They're going to do an adaptation. I heard they're going to make a book out of it, which I think is a good idea.
British people, if anything, have rallied behind the NHS now, having previously hated it. It's almost as if you insulting Britain has actually pushed us behind it. Yeah. We can insult it, but you can't. It's like using the N-word.
But Europe's like that. I mean, everything we do, they have to do the opposite. First, they're rallying around Obama. They love this guy. Yeah. He's, he's in Germany. Let's all stand outside and yell stuff and not burn things. For the first time, we'll put our lighters and our American flags back in our pockets and we'll wave them with respect, which is the only thing you should ever do with a flag. All of a sudden, we elect a guy, and then everyone over there switches to conservative government, and they're like, "Oh, now they got they got this guy. We're gonna go the other way." So, you guys just weave when we bob. Bob, we weave. It doesn't make any sense.
Yin
when we yang. You know what I'm saying? And the bottom line is, you're all a bunch of yangs, in my opinion, because your healthcare system's garbage. Your doctors. In a million years, look at me. Yeah. If I got hit by a car in England, and they said, we have to put him in a lorry or whatever you use over there to get him to the emergency room.
Yeah.
I would say, don't. Take me to the airport and get me back to New York.
But we would treat you. It wouldn't cost you anything? No, that would be on the British
hand.
What's
the difference how much it costs me if my ribs are where my ass is supposed to be? That means nothing to me. That means nothing to me. I want the best doctors in the world working on my body.
Right.
I didn't spend all this time perfecting this temple to have somebody come in and destroy it.
But I mean, so many Americans are without healthcare. 5 million Americans.
Get a job.
But I mean,
stop mooching off the system.
Yeah, but some of them have jobs but can't afford
work
insurance.
Work harder. Work harder.
Right.
It's the American dream. Right. You work hard, you get good things.
Yeah.
You don't work hard, deal with it. What I mean? And the other thing is, you don't have a job.
Yeah.
Or you do have a job and you can't afford insurance, okay. Well, then eat some carrots or something. Stop eating so many frickin' Doritos. Don't take the escalator, you fat bastard. Walk up the steps every now and then. Maybe you won't have a heart attack. You know what I'm saying?
Sort of. That's not the American way, though.
Well, you know what? You know what it is? It's reality is what it is, okay? And I've got to tell you something. This new guy comes into power, what's his face?
President Obama,
He comes in, and look, when you're American, you do one thing. You salute the flag and you bow to the president. That's the rule.
Oh, right, okay?
And I like this guy, and I'll tell you why I like him.
That's good.
Because he doesn't know what he's doing. And it's proof that you can go to Harvard and have all the connections in the world and the easiest life. I mean, how easy is this guy's life? Grew up in Hawaii.
I mean,
his dad wasn't around. I mean, it's cake. It's a cakewalk. Lives the American dream, goes to Harvard, the best school ever, the oldest school in history, and the best school.
I have to stop you there. That is simply not true.
Oh, you're talking about world history? I'm talking about American history.
Yeah. You seem to claim that American healthcare is the best in the world.
Number one.
No. I mean,
you know we did a heart transplant?
Yeah.
There's guys out there with monkey hearts?
Yeah.
Think about that. That's out of a freaking movie.
You're number 37. You're number 37 in the world.
Who does that ranking? The World Health Organization.
Yeah.
That's garbage. I mean, I guarantee you, if the American Health Organization did the ranking system, we'd be like one. And who knows more about the world than America? We got our fingers on all the strings of puppetry around the world.
Andy.
What?
Point out to him the error of his ways.
Who's number one?
I find him strangely persuasive, John.
Andy, do not phone. Do not phone.
Who's number one on that list?
Oh, hold on.
Let me guess.
I don't know.
Czechoslovakia?
No. That country doesn't exist anymore.
What, Czechoslovakia?
Yeah, it doesn't exist. It's the
Burma?
Czech Republic.
Who, Burma?
And neither do they.
Hold on. Let me take a sip of coffee here. Hold on. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you say yeah after every sip of coffee?
When it's delicious American-grown coffee, you know I do. None of that foreign crap. Yeah, you could say we're 37. You could say we're one. I would say we're one. People want to say we're 37 because they like to knock us. The bottom line is this. Say you come in to a hospital and you know, you have some kind of, I was going to say you have some kind of injury from doing some kind of carpentry, but I'm looking at you. I doubt that's going to be the case.
Yeah,
say you're playing badminton and you hurt your and you twist your ankle.
I'll probably play badminton more than I've carpentered.
So say you're going after birdie or whatever and you fucking run into the pole, okay? Yeah. And you break your nose.
Yeah.
Okay? Uh-huh. Now, look at the noses we've been able to craft in America. Look at them. Get a book of American noses that didn't look like that ahead of time. Look at Sylvester Stallone.
Yeah.
Look at a guy like David Schwimmer.
Yeah.
Look at a beauty like Jennifer Aniston. She's the most beautiful woman in the world. She wasn't before we gave her that nice nose. So who do you want to do your nose? And then go over to Europe and look at those freaking schnozzes over there. They all got bumps, they're like ski slopes over there.
We do have some.
Yeah.
He's right there, Andy. Yeah. You've got to give them that.
So in other words,
they've got some immaculate noses.
I mean, unbelievable. Now, do they work well? No, probably can't smell so good, but they look good.
Sorry, American. We're going to have to throw an American nose into this equation. I know it's a little too soon. What about Michael Jackson's nose?
You're talking about Michael Jackson's nose round 9 or 10.
Right.
Let's go back to the first round. First round of touch-ups on that guy.
That was a good nose.
Go take a peek at Thriller.
Do you know what? It was a good nose. It was a nice nose.
That is craftsmanship.
Yeah.
And I guarantee if you lift a nostril, it says USA somewhere in there, made in the USA. That is craftsmanship. Yeah. Obviously, if you keep painting over the Mona Lisa, at some point, you're going to just destroy it.
I mean, regarding healthcare, there's been some very angry town halls at the moment where lots of Americans are turning up to town hall and shouting at their senators and their Congress people.
Yeah.
Have you been turning up to shout as well?
Well, I was going to go to one, but, you know, the weather's been good, and I just got this new jet ski, and I'm dying to kind of try it out. I would shout, and not particularly because I disagree with what the congressman is saying, but like I feel like any time there's a public place where I'm allowed to shout, take advantage of it, because usually I get kicked out of places. You know, like if I'm at a Walmart and I start shouting, they're like, "Hey, sir, quiet down."
Yeah.
And I'm like, "Really? I can't buy the bullets and the gun here? This is ridiculous."
What were you trying to shout in a Walmart last time you were removed from the premises?
Well, I was just annoyed because it's like I'm going there to get a gun, and then the guy says something about a waiting list or something. I said, "Come on. I'm angry now. I want the gun now." You know what I mean? I'm not going to want the gun in 2 days or whatever it is. What's the point? This is an impulse buy.
Right.
I'm not thinking this through.
It's not
this
a jet.
This is an impulse buy.
It's not a jet ski accessory, the gun.
Yeah, this is not a jet ski accessory. Right. This is an impulse. I mean, that's something, a jet ski accessory I'm going to think about. I'm going to do some research on. But a gun, I'm like, look, what do you got in a semi-automatic? Right. I'm angry. I need one.
So
and the guy's going, sir, you seem angry. I said, yeah, I'm angry. Give me the goddamn gun. And he's like, well, you got to fill out this paperwork. What am I, going to a doctor's office over here? I didn't mean to tie it back in, but it's a little bit ridiculous.
Don't put the ideas in his head of firing a gun whilst riding his jet ski.
I was just going to ask, what kind of gun would you go for?
You know, I never thought of that. That is a good idea. The only thing is I'd have to get a gun that would work in the water. But I bet an AR-15 could get wet. Why would the SWAT team use it? I mean, they get wet, right?
They get wet.
I mean, sometimes they go into a building, the sprinklers are on, and they're still killing bad guys.
I cannot stress strongly enough that you should not be firing an automatic weapon whilst riding a jet ski.
So let's not say never.
Yeah, John,
I would imagine there will be certain situations.
How do you think we got out of Dunkirk, John?
That's a good point. I love that movie, too, by the way.
It wasn't a movie. It's an incredible moment in British history.
No, it's the one with Mel Gibson, isn't it?
No, that's not it.
He's the British guy who saves all the British people from... that bad king?
No. I mean, that's three different movies you're thinking of there. Yeah, that's Hamlet, Braveheart, and Lethal Weapon that you were obviously watching all at the same time.
I get cable. I watch so many movies, I get them mixed up. Let me give you a quick scenario. Al-Qaeda comes by water, all right? They could. Very easy to get by the Coast Guard.
Right.
Now they're coming in, invading with boats. What do I have to do to protect my homeland? I got to get on my jet ski, and I got to shoot something.
Are you saying that you are spending your summer riding up and down the Jersey Shore on a jet ski, firing at any boat that looks like it's trying to come in?
You guys put the gun idea in my head. I was just patrolling with a radio and alerting the Coast Guard when I saw what I would call suspicious activity. If I pass a boat and there's not people drinking on it and dancing to music and going very fast, they're obviously not out for fun. They're out for something else. You know, what I would call that suspicious activity.
Or they're just using the shipping route for trading.
I don't know if I can say this, but we'll go off the record for a second.
Okay.
Hold on. I'm just unplugging the mic. Yeah. Right, there we go. Every now and then, I've boarded some of those boats.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, like those big ones, because they can't...
Don't tell me any more about this.
I looked in the shipping containers just because, you know, what if it's a nuke? That's what I'm always thinking. Usually, it's just toys from Korea.
But obviously, over in England here, the whole nation has been obsessed with what's going on in the Ashes cricket series against Australia. What, I mean, have you been enjoying it?
Yeah, I mean, I'm just guessing that's kind of a joke.
I mean, no, it's cricket. It's a genuine, it's a huge sporting event in England, cricket.
Right.
England playing Australia.
No, I get it. And those games last like a couple of days or something.
Well, it's 5 days. And
five, wow, yeah. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You say interesting, but your eyes seem to be glazed. What are you thinking about right now?
Well, I'm just thinking about how many different sporting events I could go to in 5 days.
Yeah.
I can go to a hockey tournament.
Yeah.
I can see a few hockey games. I can see a few baseball games.
Yeah.
I could play a game of football. I can then watch a game of football.
Yeah.
I can then play basketball, watch basketball, get some autographs, pretend it's for my kid, and then sell it on eBay. And there's a lot of things I can do in that period of 5 days that has nothing to do with hitting a freaking widget with a smack hammer, whatever the hell that thing's called. Who wants to watch that thing for that long, you know?
We like it.
Yeah, all right. Well, that says a lot, you know. And by the way, if you get hurt playing cricket, how long does it take before you get back in the game? I would guess a long time. Or do athletes get to cut the waiting list because they're special? Do they have doctors who sit on the cricket sideline specifically for the athletes? That's a good question. I bet they do. Which means you prioritize your rich and famous over there, which is why David Beckham looks American and good.
Whoa. That guy is... yeah, no, you're right. He does. He doesn't look English.
He does not look British.
He looks amazing.
Yeah. The fact that his skin actually has melanin in it proves to me... Somewhere along the way, someone had sex with an American.
American, okay. It's been a joy to have you back on the show.
Always a pleasure to spend some time with you guys.
Good luck
always
on the jet ski. Please do not take a gun on there. Will you promise me that?
Of course. I'm not
a loaded one, anyway.
No.
Yeah.
If it's just for look, that's fine, surely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah. I mean, the ones mounted on there just shoot water right now. But...
Well, it's the last Bugle of the year, and you can tell from the tone in my voice what is about to be unleashed. Open the gates of hell. Let the smoke clear. Put out the flames. The American is here.
Kaboom, baby. What's up, everybody?
There you go. Well, wow.
Good ding.
Ticked a lot of boxes there.
Good ding. Let's do it.
Good ding. Stop saying good ding.
Hey, world. Good ding. No, get ready.
I explicitly said don't say that again.
I'm going to just real quick. I respect what you just said.
Yeah.
But good ding, everybody.
Happy holidays, American.
I don't say that. I say Merry Christmas. I don't go for that generic crap.
It's just, I mean, do you not think it's more inclusive just to say happy holidays?
Nah, really. I mean...
Well, it is. I mean, it is more inclusive to say that.
Well, not for Christians, it's not.
You're right, it isn't for that.
It's actually less inclusive to Christians. Right. I'd rather say happy every holiday to each person so they all feel special. I'll lump everybody into one group of crap.
Oh, right. So you'll just take a guess based on appearance, going, well, I'm guessing happy Hanukkah by the toot-toot.
Yeah, you can spot a Jew.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, let's be honest. I live in the Northeast. I can spot a Jew. To my left eye, really, that doesn't. My right eye doesn't pay much attention.
That is interesting that your left eye has Judah, your right eye doesn't.
Judah, yeah.
That's because of the way they had to hold the hammers when they were working in Egypt.
That's right.
It's very much a
is that right,
strong
Andy?
Left eye stance.
Yeah. Is that right?
Yep.
It goes back. It goes way back.
Way back.
I think you become a worse Jew every week, Andy.
Here's an interesting thing about Andy.
Mm-hmm.
I never get to really see Andy because he's over wherever you guys are from.
I mean, it's England. It's England.
Yeah,
it's...
I don't know, France, wherever.
No, but, I mean, it's not France. That's a different country.
By ears, I don't have an ear to spot a Jew. To me, Andy, he sounds like, you know, he could be going to church every Sunday. But
really?
I'm sure if I saw him, I go, oh, yeah, a Jew.
Not even your left ear.
You know, the truth is, with all the rock and roll music I listen to, my ears ain't what they used
really?
To be. Yeah.
When you walk into a room with your oversized headphones on, what is spilling out of that?
Well, it depends on my mood. I mean, generally, I'm going to open up my morning, like any time my alarm goes off, it's going to be someone from the Rat Pack singing a good song.
Okay.
If I don't hear Dean Martin before I get in the shower, it's not a good day. And then, you know, later in the day, I'll listen to something a little bit more tame, maybe some Sinatra.
I mean, it's basically classic standards by crooners.
good music, I like okay. to call it.
So, American, it's the end of a year, end of a decade. How's this year been for America?
I got to be honest with you, it hasn't been our best year.
It hasn't been our best year. That was what I was trying to couch in the question. You've had a bad, bad year this year.
Let's just put it in perspective. A bad year for us is still a great year for any other country.
Well, for Burundi, yes.
No. Across the board, any country in the world, we have a bad year. Their year is definitely worse. In other words, it's a pretty simple equation. When you're number one and you slip down to number three, everybody else slips down below three. So three becomes one.
What? Hold on. That's not an
equation.
You
know what I'm saying?
That's just words with some numbers thrown in.
Nah, it's math.
No,
there's a math
sure
principle. I think it's Zelig's principle or something. I forget what the guy's name.
Really?
But basically it's like
actually getting vaguer.
Whatever the top is becomes lower than the top, but the top overall just lowers, so everyone's still below the
top.
Yeah,
that literally makes less sense than when you were just arbitrarily throwing numbers in there.
All right, let me clarify this.
Yeah.
Okay. Say there's 10 countries in the world.
Okay, now I'm with you.
I know there's like 9,000, but say there's 10.
We're saying there's 10. Good.
Right.
Yeah.
So we're number one, obviously, on the 10. Let's say number two.
For the sake
of
the exercise, yeah.
Let's say number two on that list is, I don't even know who'd be two. Germany, I guess?
No.
They did it right.
No, you're thinking the early 1900s. China.
All right. Yeah, I guess the Chinese.
Yeah.
Okay. So just for argument's sake, I'll say China because I don't want to get into why they're why they're not really two.
Okay.
Canada is
10.
Okay.
They were lucky to make the 10,
yeah,
but still.
Yeah, I mean, that was nice. I did that to be nice because it's Christmas time. So now we slide down. We slide down to three.
Yes.
China, which used to be two, now becomes four. And there is no longer a one and a two. There's just it starts at three.
Here's where I got lost.
It starts at three.
Right.
Yeah, and then the Canada now is off the top 10 because everything else had to slide down.
I see.
You understand?
Now, Copenhagen Summit is taking place at the moment.
Oh, the summit. For a minute, I thought you meant the chewing tobacco. I was like, yeah, I love it.
No, I meant the summit. It's taking place over there.
One time, quick story, I'm spitting Copenhagen juice out of my mouth and it was a Snapple bottle, right? But it looks brown. My brother-in-law gets on my boat after water skiing. He gets on my boat.
Please
he's thirsty.
No. Please no.
And he's like, oh, Snapple.
No.
And before I could say, hey, Tommy, don't do it. He's taking a swig of my spit. It was hysterical.
How did that?
Hysterical. Won't let him live it down.
How did Tommy react to
that? Hysterical.
How did Tommy?
Oh, he yacked. Obviously, he yacked over the side of the boat. But he's a yacker anyway. He's one of those guys. He yacks. We hit a wave, he yacks. So he's always yacking. Who knows? Anyway, go ahead. Global summit or something. What are you saying?
The global climate change summit is taking place in Copenhagen. It's been taking place for the last week.
Yeah.
Obama is over there.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's funny.
He's still
we got so much crap going on here. He's over there talking about global summits. If he was here, he would know how cold it is outside. What are you doing? It's global what? Warming my ass.
Oh boy. Okay.
I got 14 layers. I'm going to black.
Okay, so let's try and deal with this now. Global warming, just because it's colder in the winter, it's winter now, so it will be colder.
I had to get one of my fur coats out of my cedar closet. One of my many fur coats.
Oh, boy. Please tell me it's not a polar bear coat.
No, that's disgusting.
Oh,
it's a seal coat.
Oh, come on!
Don't get carried away. It was before it was bad to kill seals.
When was that?
Like 2-3 years ago, before it was a big deal. And it's not like we clubbed them or anything. It's not like we used a crowbar.
What did you do?
It was a sword. Very sharp sword.
A sword?
1-2 swings, the thing's dead. It's an Eskimo tradition. I used to date an Eskimo. Well, I thought actually she was Mexican. She looked like an Eskimo.
I really would like to confront, on behalf of the future of the planet, this idea that there is no global warming because it's cold outside in December here.
Right. Look, I'm not going to get into the reality of the conspiracy, but I could tell you this.
Yes.
Let's say Tipper Gore, what's that guy's name?
Al Gore.
Chubby guy. Let's say he's right about all his stuff.
Yeah.
And I didn't see that movie just because, you know, I don't know. I think 300 was on or something. Why would I watch a guy who's out of shape when I could watch 300 guys in shape?
Incredible shape.
Incredible shape. Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, really, have you seen that, Andy?
300.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, those guys are pumped.
Look, one of those guys shows up, what are you going to do?
Yeah.
You know, not blow him?
Yeah.
Let's say Al Gore is right.
Yeah.
Okay. People are scared. They say, oh, you know, we're going to die because the world's going to heat up.
Yes.
And this is what they always say in the apocalypse. The only thing that's going to be left are rats and cockroaches. Humans are the third thing. We're like rats and cockroaches. We're not like the snow leopard.
We're not like the elephant. We don't need special environments to live. We can live underwater. We can live on land. We can live in the air. We can live on the moon.
We can't do any
of those
things.
We're an adaptable species, just like rats and cockroaches.
No.
We will eat whatever it takes to survive. We will live wherever it takes to survive. Personally, my guess is Bayonne, New Jersey is going to be fine. I won't have to move. If other places go on the water, move Midwest. Big deal. So we'll put some Olive Gardens in the Midwest. Everybody will be fine, you know?
Does wherever Jersey moves, does that become Jersey? Is that like your theory of
Absolutely.
Maths from before?
I mean, if Jersey goes on the water, you know, the next state over, Pennsylvania, boom, New Jersey.
American, thank you. I guess is the right phrase. Thank you for joining us.
Fellas, I have to say, Happy New Year. God bless to you and your families.
Okay, thank you.
Salute.
Salute, and salute to you.
Have a very American Christmas.
And remember, and listen, guys, Andy, I know you're a Jew, but anything you need for Christmas or something, you just give me, a ring. You have my direct number.
Yeah, okay.
Don't give that out, by the way, but that'll get you things.
Thank you, American.